Hello friends, this is Ayush and in this video we'll be discussing the quant section of CMAT 2020 paper. In this video we'll be having questions from the chapters percentage, profit loss, simple and compound interest, ratios and proportions, averages and data interpretation. So let's begin with the same. Here's question number one. The question is from SICA, that's simple and compound interest. Let's start solving the same. A company publishes to its customers that at a certain rate, compound interest rate, a sum of money deposited by anyone will become 8 times in 3 years. So, since the principal is not given to us, I am assuming it to be 100. The amount is becoming 8 times, that is 800 in a duration of 3 years and the rate is not given to us. So, let's try to calculate the rate. The amount is equals to principal into 100 plus r upon 100 raised to the power 3, right? So what we'll have is double zero will get cancelled out. This cube will go on the other side and it will be cube root of 8, which is 2, equals to 100 plus r upon 100. On cross multiplying, we'll have 200 equals to 100 plus r, and on solving, we'll finally get r equals to 100%, right? So here the rate of interest is 100. Now, what is happening next? If the same amount is deposited at compound rate of interest, if the same amount, matlab now the again principal is 100 only, in how many years will it be 16 times? So amount here will be 1600. The time is not given to us, but rate, as we know in the previous case, was 100. So here it will be the same 100%, and time is something that we don't know. So let's try to calculate this. 1600 equals to 100. Into 100 plus 100 upon 100 raised to the power t. Double zero to double zero will get cancelled out. It is 16 equals to 100 plus 100. That is 200 upon 100, which is 2 only. So 2 raised to the power t. 16 is 2 raised to the power 4, which is equal to 2 raised to the power t. On solving, we'll have t equal to 4. So for question number 1, the correct answer is option A, that is 4 years. So in 4 years, the amount will be 16 times of itself. It's the answer. Let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 2 is on the screen. So let's try to solve it out. It's a question based on ratio and proportion. So let's try to figure it out. X is to Y is given to us 2 is to 3. So here I'm assuming X equal to 2K and Y equal to 3K. Putting the value of X and Y in the given expression, 2X plus 5Y. So it will be 3 into 2k plus 2 into 3k upon 2 into 2k plus 5 into 3k. This will be 6k plus 6k upon 4k plus 15k. So this, which will be 12k upon 19k, and this kk will get cancelled out. So we'll have the answer as 12 upon 19. So for question number 2, the correct answer is option D, that is 12 upon 19. Let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 3, again a question from interest only. Let's try to figure it out. 25,000 is borrowed. Matlab the principal given to us is 25,000. At the rate of interest of 3% for the first year, there are different rates of interest that is applicable. 3%, then 4% and 5% for the first 3 years, first, second and third year. We have to calculate the amount. So in this case, amount can be calculated as principal multiplied by 100 plus R1 upon 100 raised to the power T, but T will be 1 only because 3% is applicable only for 1 year. 100 plus R2 upon 100 raised to the power T, again that will be 1 year, and 100 plus 5 upon 100 raised to the power 1. So on solving, we'll have 25,000 into 103 upon 100 into 104 upon 100 into 105 upon 100. I'll just cancel out double zero say double zero. This zero and this zero will get cancelled out. 25 say cancel karta. This is 1 and this is 4. 4 say cancel karta. This is 1 and this is 26. 2 say cancel karta. This is 13 and this is 5. 5 say cancel karta. This is 1 and this is 21. So ultimately the calculation left is 103 into 13 into 21. We even don't need to solve this entirely. We can just check it out. It's 3 into 3 into 1. That is the unit digit should be 9, which is only applicable in one of the options. So the correct answer here on multiplying that will be get is 281119. So option D, 281119 is the correct answer for question number 3. Question number 4, it's a question based on discount profit loss. So let's try to take it up. Two successive discounts of 8% and 12% are applicable. So since the mark price is not given to us, I'm assuming it to be 100 rupees, and the discounts that were given were 8% plus 12%. So first of all, let's calculate what would be the selling price in a case like this. It is MP 100 minus D1 upon 100 into 100 minus D2 upon 100. So we'll have 100 into 92 upon 100 into 88 upon 100. 100's 100 will get cancelled out. 92 into 88 is 8096 upon 100, which is 80.96. So the article which was purchased, which was marked at rupees 100, was sold for rupees 80.96. So the actual discount, overall discount given was 19.04%, which is the correct answer for this question. Question number 4, the correct answer is option B. Let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 5 is on the screen. Again, a question from profit loss. So let's try to figure it out. Shopkeeper marks his books 25% above the cost price. The cost price is not given to us. So I'm assuming that the cost price of the article was 100, right? So the mark price of the article will be 125. Due to slump in the market, his cost reduces by 5%. So the new cost price after reduction of 5% will be 95. And to boost his sale, he offered a discount of 8%. Since no discount was mentioned in the first case, so I'm assuming the discount in the first case to be 0%. In that case, my selling price in the first case will be 125, and profit in the first case will be 25 rupees, right? And here the mark price is again 125, but now he's offering a discount of 8%. So selling price will be, after a reduction of 8% in 125, we'll have 115. And the profit will be 20 per article, right? Now what is happening? But his sales goes up by 25%. Now, this is something that we were assuming for one article. In the first case, let us assume the total sale was 100 articles. So total profit was 2500. In the second case, the sale goes up by 25%. Now he is selling 125 articles. So the profit will be 20 into 125. That will be 2500 again. What they have asked us in the question is the change in shopkeeper's profit. As we can see, in the first case, he was earning 2500. Now again, he is earning 2500 only. So there is no change in the shopkeeper's profit. So option A, no change, is the correct answer for question number 5. Let's go ahead for question number 6. Tom's salary. Again, a question based on percentage. So Tom's salary is 150% of John's salary. So I am assuming John's salary is 100 rupees. Tom's salary will be 150% of this, that is 150 rupees. And Steve's salary, John's salary is 80% of Steve's salary. So this John's salary of 100 is 80% of Steve's salary. So on solving, we'll have Steve equals to 100 into 100 upon 80, which will give us the salary of Steve as 125. Now what they have asked is the ratio of Steve's salary to Tom's salary. They have asked us the ratio of Steve's salary to Tom's salary, that is 125 is to 150. 25 segments cancel karta hu, I'll have the ratio is 5:6. So the correct answer for question number 6, a very basic question from percentage, is option D, that is 5:6. Let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 7, it's a question based on the concept of averages. So let's try to figure it out. 5 years ago, 5 years ago, the average age of A, B, C, and D was 45 years, right? So A plus B plus C plus D, average age divided by 4 was 45. So their total age at that point of time was 45 into 4, that is 180 years. Now, if we are talking about the present, so present mein their average age must also have increased by 5 years only. So A plus B plus C plus D in present must have got an average age of 50. So A plus B plus C plus D becomes 200. Matlab their total age at this point of time in present is 200 years. Now what happens? By including X in the present plot to their present average changes to 49. If they'll include X as well, so this will be A plus B plus C plus D plus X. The average will be divided by 5 because there will be 5 individuals in the group now. 49. So on multiplying, I'll have A plus B plus C plus D plus X equals to 49 to 5, that is 245, in which we have already known of the fact that A plus B plus C plus D is 200. So I'll put the value 200 plus X equal to 245. On solving, I'll have X equals to 45 years. So the correct answer, what they have asked us in the question, is the present age of X. X ka present age is 45 years. Option B is the correct answer for this question. Right, let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 8 is on the screen. It's a question again from averages. Let's try to figure it out. A city has an average demand of water for 33,000 liters of water, which lasts for 50 days. So total water requirement, if total water availability will be 33,000 is the average consumption per day, and 50 days ke liye it will last. On multiplying, I'll have 165,000, that is 1,650,000 is the total units of water, liters of water available with us. Now what happens is, but if some people enter the city, the demand increases to 37,000 liters of water for supply, which will last 35 days. Now there is a confusion in the language. This 35 days means that the people who are entering the city will be staying in the city for 35 days, right? So for water consumption of 35 days, if we calculate, that will be 37,000 into 35, which will be 1,295,000. Matlab, the water that was consumed in 35 days was 1,295,000. Right. So the remaining water that we have for the remaining days is subtracting 1,650,000 and 1,295,000, we'll get 3,55,000. So we are having 3,55,000 liters of water with us, and it should last for 50 days in total. Matlab, this water is to be used in 15 remaining days. So per day ka consumption, if we have to calculate per day consumption, what we'll do is we'll divide 355,000 by 15, which on division will give us 23,666.66 liters. Right. So the correct answer for question number 8 is option B, that is 23,666.66 liters. Let's go ahead for the next question. Okay. So this is the question from data interpretation part. We'll have a set, and I guess there'll be 4 questions in this set. So it's the first set, but before entering into the question, we'll just go through the data that is given to us. Number of boys and girls in 100. Matlab, the data is given to us in 100. So for school A, the number of boys in 2014 is 3.3 in 100. Matlab, a total of 3.3 into 100, 330 boys were there. In 6 different years, in 5 different schools, data is given to you. Perfect. Let's go to the question. Question is, what is the approximate percentage decrease in the number of boys in school D in the year 2017? Number of boys in school D in the year 2017. So rate is given to us as 5.3 as compared to the previous year. So previous year mein, number of boys in school D in the previous year was 6.4. So what is the decrement? So if we'll calculate the decrement will be of 6.4 minus 5.3. And if we have to calculate the percentage, so we'll compare it with 6.4. So upon 6.4 into 100, that will be 1.1 upon 6.4 into 100. which on solving, like suppose we'll remove the decimal to decimal, we'll have 11 upon 66, 64. Now, if it would have been 11 upon 66, that would have been 1 by 6, which is 16.66%. So it will be slightly greater than 16.66%. If we'll go by option, as it is given to us that we have to calculate it approximately, the correct option should be 17%. So for question number 9, option A, 17% is the correct answer. Let's go for the next question. Question number 10 is on the screen based on the same data. Now let's get to the question directly. The number of girls in school B, in the year 2018, is 5.9. Is approximately what percent of the total number of students in school E, in the year 2015. So, girls in school E is 5.9 upon total number of students in school E for the year 2015 is 5.5 plus 3.6, which is 9.1. So this will be 9.1 into 100. Decimal se decimal remove karte hain, right? So on solving, we'll have 59 upon 91 into 100, which will be approximately equals to 65%. So for question number 10, option B, that is 65%, is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question on the same data. Question number 11 is on the screen. What is the average number of girls in school A in all the years taken together? Now, if we have to calculate the average number of girls in school A in all the years taken together, we have to add all these values. That is 3.6 plus 4.2 plus 6.9 plus 9.6 plus 12.9 plus 14.4. And we need to divide it by 6. Now, suppose if I add all these values, I'll have, I guess it's 51.6, which will be divided by 6 to give us 8.6. So the average number of girls is 8.6, but the data is in 100. So what I'll do is I'll multiply it by 100. I'll get the answer as 860. So for question number 11, the correct answer is option A, that is 860. Let's go ahead for the next question. Question number 12 is on the screen. Again, based on the same data, what is the ratio of number of boys in school C in 2018? This is the data. So the number of girls in school A in 2018. This is the data. So we have to find the ratio of 8.7 upon 12.9. Decimal se decimal remove karta hun. And 3 se cancel karta hun. This will be 29. 3 se cancel karta hun. This will be 43. So the correct answer for question number 12 is 29 is to 43. That is option A. So option A is the correct answer for question number 12. So friends, with this, we are done with this video. We have solved questions based on certain topics like percentage, profit loss and all. Right. I hope the questions must be clear to you. In case if you have any kind of queries, you can post it on our Facebook page. We will be solving the questions of the remaining topics of CMAT 2020 quant section in the coming video. Thank you for watching the video.